بسم الله الحمد لله رب العالمين هو الذي جعل المسلمين والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله السلام عليكم. Alhamdulillah, usually I just go right into the program, but I couldn't help but hear the mention of someone I know very well who happened to be there when I made Shahada in 1991, Sheikh Muhammad Jabali, who he just was talking about, actually lives in Medina now, but when he was doing his degree work in Texas, he was there in Arlington, Texas. And that particular masjid right there was, in those days, the only one we had. So that happens to be the same place where I did Shahada. And he is a great guy. Since then, alhamdulillah, we've shared the podium a number of times together. He's also formerly the head of the QSS, the Quran and Sunnah Society in the United States, if you ever heard of it. And they still have a website up. So he's a good guy. Get some of his stuff is on one of our websites called watchislam.com. So, the topic tonight we're going to talk about is a subject that I think is probably, at least to some extent, a valid topic to every one of us. It's a subject of responding or being able to answer the harsh attacks and criticisms that are coming toward Islam, the Muslims, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and every aspect of Islam. And I don't mean by this clearing up misconceptions. This is another subject. I'm talking about people who are intentionally attacking Islam, or people who are following those who are intentionally attacking Islam. Now, how many of you speak Arabic to come out of here? How many? About half? Alhamdulillah, this is good. Because you understand this very quick. If I talk to you about those who are Arab Christians and Jews, then you know exactly what I'm talking about. But I will mention to you now something from the Quran, and this is for all of us to think about, when Allah says, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu, attaqullah wa kullu qalbin sadida. You hear this in the Juma khutbah, in the khutbah or speech that we have every Friday, along with some of the other ayahs of the Quran, but the meaning behind it is very powerful. That Allah is telling the believers to have taqwa for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but then always we have to say the truth. Throughout the Quran, you'll see there's this comparison between truth and falsehood, truth and falsehood. Even in the translations, you cannot help but pick it up. The haq and the batil. When someone is speaking the truth, or if somebody is kadhib, a liar, these things are constantly coming up over and over and over throughout the Quran from the beginning up until the very end. Even at the very last surah of the Quran, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about the waswas, and the waswas coming inside your heart from the jinn of mankind, and certainly you don't think he's waswasing the truth to you, so obviously you can see this from the beginning, from the very beginning, and all the way through the Quran, the subject of truth and falsehood being on the haq or being elsewhere. That Islam is the only answer, it's the only solution. There isn't an option really to go to look at anything else. And as Muslim, we realize the value of telling the truth in everything we do anyway. We don't see any benefit in lying. Even a temporary benefit isn't really there. We know that you have to tell the truth. Even if it's against yourself, your family, you know the truth is the truth, and you have to say the truth. And this is what one of the great things that makes us Muslim is that we know what the truth is, and this is what we operate off of. This is how we function, is from the standpoint of the truth. How critical is it to us when somebody talks about the Quran, and the Quran is coming to us today from a Rawaya or Ijaza for how many centuries, but it's still exactly the same today as it was when it was revealed. This is, I mean, if I don't understand that, I don't even understand what's the Quran, right? You gotta understand, this is a basic thing. The Quran is not changed, meaning what? That means that every time people said it exactly the way it was. In other words, they didn't add to it, take away from it. It's exactly the same. This is why sometimes you hear people when they say Allah is Haq, well that's His name, of Haq. The Deen is Haq, it's the truth. The Quran is Haq. And Prophet ﷺ is of course on the Haq. So this Haq or truth, absolute truth, is, we take it for granted. This is why when they want to compare their books, whatever they have, said that. We listen to them out of politeness, we listen out of curiosity, but never would we be able to accept even the first verse when they start to recite it, especially if you've heard the Bible in Arabic. Anybody heard the Bible in Arabic? I left it in the room in the hotel. I wanted to bring it and let you hear it. Just wanted to let you hear it, but for whatever reason the Lord didn't let me bring it. I didn't think about it till we were gone. But you can get it any time you want to look at it. Any hotel or motel has, right beside the bed, a little nightstand or something there. You pull the drawer open. There's a book in there. What's the book? It ain't the yellow pages. Somebody ought to beat you to that one. No, it's the Bible. It's put there by the Gideon Society. And they're proud of the fact that they have translated this into 27 different languages. And they will show you that with an example of a verse in the Gospel of St. John, chapter 3, verse 16. They call it chapter 16. It's the one, if you've ever heard them preach it, they say, for God so loved the world, and you go on from there. When it says that, and you find the word Allah in Arabic, which is the second language, first one is Arabic, comes in Arabic, you see it, says, for Allah so loved the world. So it's very clear, but when you try to read it, you're going to look at it and you're going to say, oh, it's not even correct grammar. If you know Fusha, which is the Arabic, classical Arabic, and you read it, you're going to go, who did this? You'll never be fooled, not even for a second. I was thinking, actually, when I was looking at it tonight, that when we have these opportunities, when we have so many of the Arab Christians who do come to the programs, and they want to do this attacking thing that I was talking about, and by the way, it happened in Sydney the last time I was here, really nasty. But I was thinking, wouldn't it be something to let them say, okay, you got your guys with you, choose whoever you like, let them stand up, and then choose any verse you like, and if you don't have one memorized in your language, because they won't, here's the Bible that we pulled out of the hotel, just read that verse for us, in your best voice, go ahead. Then, listen to this, choose any one of our guys that memorized the Quran, anybody, I don't care, pick the one you like. And then you go pick the verse, any verse you like from the Quran. Okay, then you recite, or let our guy recite, and let all those who don't know listen and see which one they like. I have no doubt what will happen. Because I've seen people who didn't know anything about